Hello students, in our today's session we are going to study about the hydrogen bonds related to chemical bonding. A hydrogen bond is an intermolecular force that form a special type of dipole-dipole interaction between a hydrogen atom which is bonded very strongly to a strongly negative electronegative atom, that is fluorine, oxygen, nitrogen. And hydrogen bonds are stronger than the ordinary dipole-dipole interactions when a dipole and dipole are having the force of interaction between them and the dispersion forces. But these are weaker than the true covalent and ionic bond. So this thing has to be remembered for the arrangement type questions, that the hydrogen bond is stronger than the dipole-dipole and dispersion forces, but they are weaker than the true covalent and ionic bonds. So let us see how the hydrogen bonds takes place, the formation takes place. So this is the example of water. Oxygen is electronegative, hydrogen is positive in nature. So we can see that electropositive and electronegative develop a special type of dipole-dipole interaction, which is especially given a new name, that is the hydrogen bond. Because it is the hydrogen atom which is bonded in this case with a strong electronegative atom, that is the fluorine, oxygen, or nitrogen. So we can see a very simple example in case of water. Similar other various examples are present in case of ammonia, in case of HF, when hydrogen is bonded on one side to the electronegative atom and then on the other side it is forming a dipole interaction with the other electronegative atom. So let us see that what are the main conditions for the hydrogen bond. The most important thing, the molecule must contain a highly electronegative atom, which is linked to the hydrogen bond. So in the above example, you have seen that on the one side, it is having a covalent bond and on the other side, it is having the hydrogen bond with the electronegative atom, that is FO or N. So the first condition is the molecule must contain a highly electronegative atom, which is linked to the hydrogen atom. And it is a very important thing that higher the electronegativity, more is the polarization of the molecule. Now the second thing, the size of the electronegative atom should be small. We know that smaller the size, greater is the electrostatic force of attraction. So the two main conditions are, one, the hydrogen atom must be linked to a highly electronegative atom. And the other thing, the electronegative atom should be small, because the smaller the size, greater is the electrostatic attraction. Now there are two types of hydrogen bond. One is known as the intermolecular hydrogen bond and the other is known as the intramolecular hydrogen bond. As the name itself suggests, inter and intra. When we talk about the intermolecular hydrogen bond, then this is the hydrogen bond which takes place between different molecules of the same or different compound. It is not at all necessary that both the molecule must be of the same compound. They may be of the different compounds also. For example, hydrogen bonding in water, hydrogen bonding in alcohol. So let us see some example here. For example, when we talk about hydrogen bonding in water, as we have seen in the above diagram also, water is having a band shape. So we can draw the various band shape structures here for the water molecule. Even with these two water molecule, we can show the hydrogen bonding. H is electropositive, O is electronegative. A hydrogen bond is formed. Similarly, a hydrogen bond can also exist with the other molecules also. H will remain the positive in nature, the electropositive sign on it, and O becomes the electronegative. So a hydrogen bond between the water molecules. Similarly, we can show the hydrogen bond between the alcohol molecules also. For example, ROH, a simple representation for the alcohol. Then again, ROH. ROH is a representation for the alcohol. We can show that the hydrogen bonding is developed in between the H of one and the O of the other. So intermolecular hydrogen bonding, the basic requirement for intermolecular hydrogen bonding is that it take place between different molecules of same or the different compound. It can also exist between alcohol and water also, because alcohol has H and water has alcohol and water both are having O and H, which can form the hydrogen bonding with each other. Now come the case of the intramolecular H bonding. Dear student, in case of intramolecular H bonding, the H bonding will take place within a molecule itself. That is, within the molecule, the H bonding is going to take place. A very, very important example of this case is orthonitrophenol. So phenol is a benzene ring with O and H, that is the OH part on it. And on the other side, at the ortho term is for the second position. This is the first position and this is the second. When we are placing NO2 on it, this is known as the orthonitrophenol. In the common language, in the common form, it is known as orthonitrophenol. So hydrogen being electropositive, oxygen being electronegative, a force of attraction is developed between the H positive and the O negative, which is known as the intramolecular H bonding. This is the case of orthonitrophenol. And in the IUPAC name, it is known as 2-nitrophenol. This is the intramolecular H bonding. The other main thing about the intramolecular H bonding, it takes place in the compound containing two groups such that one group contains hydrogen atom linked to an electronegative atom and the other group contains a highly electronegative atom linked to a lesser electronegative atom. As we have seen that in this case, H is linked to a very strong electronegative oxygen. And on the other side, there is also the presence of N, which is less electronegative as compared to O. So this is a condition for the intramolecular H bonding. And due to intramolecular H bonding, the H of OH and the O of NO2 are linked to each other. So what we have discussed till now, that what is hydrogen bonding, what are the various conditions of hydrogen bonding, and the two types of hydrogen bonding, that is the inter and the intramolecular H bonding. Now let us come to a very important difference between the H bond and a covalent bond. H bond or a hydrogen bond involves the dipole-dipole attractive interaction. There is a dipole-dipole attractive interaction, but in a covalent bond, there is a mutual sharing of electrons between the two atoms. In case of hydrogen bond, the H atom is linked to a highly electronegative atom such as FO or N, the fluorine, oxygen or nitrogen. But in covalent bond, there is a mutual sharing of electron between the two electronegative atoms, the two non-metals we are usually talking about, the two electronegative atoms, which may be of the same element or of the different element. Now comes the third point. In case of the hydrogen bond, the strength of bond is very small. The strength of the bond is very small. For example, in case of HF, it is 41.8 kilojoule per mole. But when we talk about the covalent bond strength, it is sufficiently high. For example, in case of H2 molecule, which is hydrogen bond, which is a covalently bonded molecule, the bond strength is 433 kilojoule per mole. So this is the difference between the H bond and a covalent bond. Now let us do some very important tips or correctors or reasoning based questions from the H bond. Various very, very important reasoning based questions on hydrogen bond. So let us start with the first example of it. The unusually high boiling point of HF among the other halogen acids, for example, HF, HCl, HBr, HI. So we are talking about the halogen acids. Among the halogen acids, that is the HX, when we compare the boiling point, it is found that the boiling point of HF is very high, which is due to existence of hydrogen bonding. We can show the structure of HF in the crystalline or solid state. The HF exists as the F and H, and there is a linkage in between H and F, H of one, and the F of the other molecule. A formation of hydrogen bond takes place, then F and H, and similar type of pattern is obtained when we are talking about HF in the solid state. Due to this, it is having a very high hydrogen, a very high boiling point. Now it is the intermolecular H bonding. Now the other similar example, water is a liquid while H2S or H2SC or H2TE, all are gases at ordinary temperature. It is because in case of water, there exists hydrogen bonding that results in causing association of the water molecule. The water molecule undergoes association. For example, as just we have drawn the structure of water molecule before also, there exists the hydrogen bonding in between the various water molecules. So it can be shown like this, O of one and the H of the other. There is formation of H bond, O of one and the H of the other. In case of water, there is twice del negative charge on it. Hydrogen is having the positive charge. Again, we can easily see that there is formation of electropositive and electronegative dipole-dipole interaction, which is given a special name, that is the hydrogen bond. So because of this type of bonding, the association occurs in between the various water molecules, and water exists in the liquid state. While this is missing in case of H2S, H2SC, and H2TE, hydrides of sulfur, selenium, tellurium, so they exist in the gaseous state. Now there came the other case of NH3 and the other third electronegative element. NH3 has higher boiling point than pH3. Again, the same reason, in case of NH3, there exists the hydrogen bonding, but not in case of pH3. pH3 is known as phosphine. So ammonia is higher boiling point than phosphine because in case of ammonia, there exists the hydrogen bonding between electronegative N and the electropositive H of the one and the other molecule. Now the other fourth important characteristic example of this, ethanol has higher boiling point than ether. Ethanols are, dear student, ROH, and the ethers are ROR. So alcohols are having higher boiling point than the case of the ether. It is because in case of alcohol, there exists H bonding, but this H bonding is missing in case of the ethers. So in case of alcohols, that is R is taken equal to C2H5. In case of ethanol, there exists the hydrogen bond, but it is missing in case of the ethers. So we can show if R is taken as C2H5, then H positive, O negative results in developing the intermolecular H bond, and this will result in increasing the boiling point of the alcohols. Now, the fifth one, the compound which can form H bond with the solvent molecule are found to be soluble in such solvent. That is, if a compound is able to create a H bond with the solvent molecule, then it will going to be soluble in water. So alcohol, in case of alcohol, H bond with the solvent makes it soluble. So alcohols are soluble in water. So how they are soluble in water, let us see. Let us see the example of lower alcohol, methanol, ethanol. Then the solubility is considered with the water. So H of the alcohol, which is electropositive in nature, is treated with the O negative part and they forms the intermolecular H bond. So the alcohols are soluble in water because the alcohol and water are associated with the hydrogen bond. Similarly, it can also happen that with all other ethanol molecules, a hydrogen bonding can be shown. But simply one ethanol with one water we can see here. Now come the other example. Compounds having intermolecular H bonding have higher boiling point, so they are less volatile. It is a very important reasoning question related to orthonitrophenol and paranitrophenol. The one which is having the intermolecular H bonding, that is in between the two different molecules or two similar molecules, resulting in the development of H bond. So if there is intermolecular H bonding, then the boiling point is going to be very high. So we will compare the two examples here. One is the orthonitrophenol and the other is paranitrophenol. This example is also given in class 12 in the lesson alcohol, phenol and ether. So orthonitrophenol and paranitrophenol, let us see, both are having a nearly similar formula, but how they are different from each other. So in case of orthonitrophenol, ortho position is the second position. So in case of orthonitrophenol, we can see that a hydrogen bonding is developed in between O of NO2 part and H of the OH part. This is O negative, H positive, and a hydrogen bond is formed. This type of bonding, we have learned that it is known as intramolecular H bonding. In the types of bonding we have discussed, it is intramolecular H bonding. Now let us see another example of para. Para is the fourth position. Now if on the fourth position of benzene ring, OH is present and NO2 is present here. On the para position, the nitro is present and OH is present on the one position. So drawing the NO2 here, we can show that there is also a formation of H bonding in case of the para-nitrophenol also. So how the H bonding is created? Let us have a look of it. In between O and H. Again, we can see. So this is considered as intermolecular H bonding. Due to intermolecular H bonding, a long chain-like structure is created in between the para-nitrophenol or the other name for it is 4-nitrophenol. Phenols are a benzene ring with the OH. So in this case, it is 4-nitrophenol. And in the first case, it is 2-nitrophenol. In case of 2-nitrophenol, there is formation of the intramolecular H bonding. And in case of the para-nitrophenol, there is intermolecular H bonding. The intermolecular H bonding goes on increasing and making the chain longer. So the boiling point of 4-nitrophenol or para-nitrophenol is very high as compared to ortho-nitrophenol. Or we can say that ortho-nitrophenol is steam volatile. It is steam volatile while para-nitrophenol needs a higher boiling point. A very, very important reasoning question of class 12th also. Now the other case. Ice is having a lower density than water. Ice is made from water, but still it floats on water. So what is the reason why ice floats on water? So in case of solid ice, we have seen so many structures of water from the beginning that there is a hydrogen bonding. But when we talk about the solid ice, the H bonding results in formation of a cage-like structure. So let us have a look of the cage-like structure. So students, you can see that the H positive nature and the oxygen is going to be electronegative. There is formation of a hydrogen bonding in between the various water molecules existing there. So putting the charges on O and hydrogen, we can see that there is a formation of a large amount of hydrogen bonding in between the various water molecules. So this give rise to a cage-like structure. There is a vacant space in between. And we can also assume here and see in the other diagram that each of the water molecule is going to be tetrahedrally arranged. And each of the water molecule is linked to four other water molecule. You can see that one water molecule, which is represented here, is linked to four other water molecules in a tetrahedral arrangement. There is a vacant space in between also. So due to this, the molecules are not so closely packed as they were in the liquid state. That is the main reason. In case of ice, there is a vacant space, the cage-like structure. So the molecules are not so closely associated as in case of the liquid state. So when ice melts, this cage-like structure collapses and the molecule come closer to each other. So the volume increases and the density decreases. But till that time, the ice is having the lower density than water at 273 Kelvin. So ice floats on water. And the basic reason is cage-like structure and each of the water molecule is tetrahedrally arranged. Now comes the case that water is having a maximum density at 277 or 4 degrees Celsius. So what happens till 0 degree? At 273 Kelvin, there is sufficient H bonding in case of ice. There is a cage-like structure. It is having a larger volume. It is having a lower density. So ice floats on water. But as soon as the heating process takes place, the H bonding starts collapsing. It starts breaking. The molecules start coming close to each other. Each of the water molecule, which is having a vacant space, a cage-like structure, now the bonding, H bonding starts collapsing and the water molecule starts coming close to each other. Due to this, there is a decrease in volume and there is an increase in density, maximum till 277 Kelvin. But again, after 277 Kelvin, there is increase in volume. The volume starts increasing due to expansion of the liquid. We know that with the increase in temperature, the liquid starts expanding. But till 4 degrees Celsius, the volume is decreasing as the bonding is collapsing. But after 277, there is increase in volume, expansion of liquid takes place, water becomes much more than decrease in, and there we can see that there is expansion of liquid which takes place, and due to this expansion of liquid, water becomes much more than the decrease in volume due to breaking of the H bond. Now, thus after 277 Kelvin, there is net increase of volume on heating or decrease in density. So it is only till 277 Kelvin that the density of water is going to be maximum. So density of water is maximum up to 277 Kelvin. This is also a reasoning question. So in today's session, dear students, we have discussed about hydrogen bond, its type, its condition, and various important reasonings which are associated with the H bond. So revise these things thoroughly. Have a good day.